attacks. Today, we pray for all those who are faithful today. Pray for their families. Pray for all those who committed their lives to work for peace, to work for a better world. Pray for our country today. I God help us to be a more just, more fair, more safe, more hospitable environment. I am living where I live, especially those deployed in harm's way at this time. Pray for their safety and pray for their safe return back home. I'll invite you for us to sing. If you have from your hymn books, we want to sing Faith of Our Fathers. Faith of Our Fathers. And I think that should be.
To his altar in heaven may be acceptable. I also offer this mass for your own private intentions. Ask for mercy. For all those dedicated to working for peaceful and more safe society, we ask. Have mercy. Bless our sins. May He bring us life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father most gracious, we recall the day when our country was savagely attacked of those we lost. Remember and honor their lives, their deeds, and their deaths. May we again resolve that by their death, that their deaths will never be in vain. But may we as citizens of a nation firm to keep the peace that others have given their lives to win. May we seek to overcome our divisions and petty battles and build a nation responsible in its decisions and compassionate in its aspirations. Bless and comfort the families of those whom we honor today. Fill them with pride that is truly justified, and a comfort that only you can. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, wonder forever.
is at the right hand of God and is interceding for Christ, for hardship, for persecution, for your sake. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor death, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of Christ God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response, I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory. Because of your kindness, because of your truth, why should the pagans say,
I will walk in the Lord.
Their idols are silver and gold, the handiwork of men.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
They have mouths but speak not. They have eyes but see not. They have ears but hear not. They have hands but feel not. They have noses but smell not.
I will walk in the land of the living.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord.
My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
All this I have told you, so that you will fall away. They will put you out of the synagogue. In fact, coming, when anyone who kills you will think offering service to God. They will do such things because they have not known the Father or me. I have told you this. Very truly I tell you, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You will for a lot of people. Believe it or not, there are too many people in our country who still bear the scars of what happened. Families. Part of our history for the rest of our lives. Our children and our children's children. If they have this. We only think about the 3,000 plus that we lost on that day. Sometimes we don't think about those who got involved. So we cannot sit down and watch this happen to us again. In the deserts of Iraq and Afghanistan. The times when we don't remember them too. But as I think about the 3,000 plus that we lost, I think about the many more thousands that we lost following 9/11. This was a costly. For the rest of their lives. I think about their families that have to tolerate me to do something like this. I would question if it was indeed God. Because God would never ask you to do something this monstrous in his name. But the Lord said that we'll do things like this, thinking in your own mind, I want. Of social. Now, 9/11 was just one day. But we live in a world that is constantly under attack. We live in a nation that is constantly under attack, believe it or not. A lot of the world envies America. They want to see. I hope that like you and like everyone else, what all of those young men and women did following 9/11 of our commit to the defense of the better, most of them did not live to see that world. They gave their lives. See, today we are in the midst of another kind of event where we don't have people throwing bombs at us or blowing up, but we are under some kind of attack too from powers trying to undermine our electoral process, trying to cause harm, divisions, trying to sow hate between people, and indeed for the progress of our country. I can't tell you what to do. You must choose what you want to do. You must answer the call of the Venerable J.F. Kennedy. Ask what you can do for your country. Yeah, where we live from is wonderful. It's awesome. But where we live from will not be enough. You need to daily commit to making sure you make this country safe, you make this country resilient, you make this country habitable and hospitable. That would be the only way we can honor this day and truly remember this day. Or otherwise, all we're doing is we're reenacting a ceremony. This day must transform you as a person, must transform me, must transform our country as people to think about how best we can give to our country. So I encourage you. So listen to these words. Scripture tells us again that nothing can separate us from God's love. See, those who attacked us believed they could separate us, they could make us so fearful. And there were so many people who stopped believing God after that day because they could not understand how a loving God would sit back and see something like that happen. Yes, there was a winner. The winner was the one who wanted to sow that kind of cynicism. But as believers, Jesus said, I'm saying this to you just to warn you. Things like this will happen. So be vigilant. Someone said, eternal vigilance is a price we pay Don't be a willing or an unwilling, but unknowing tool to our enemies. You could be. Any one of us could be. We must be careful what we do, one to person to person. We must not allow the color of our skin to divide us. We must not allow how we vote to divide us. We must not allow our age or anything to divide us. We must recognize that either we thrive together as people or we are apart from each other. We cannot do both. We must as believers. We must choose our actions. Our enemies will not. And as we listen to God's nothing can keep us away from this. And we celebrate this day. And we pray for this day. This day will be the day. So let's like to end my reflections by reminding the light of God Almighty. Even in a moment like this, when our hearts are fearful, our hearts are sad, our hearts are scared, we trust Him in the power of God to protect, to shield.
No.
Let us go to God. Lift our hearts. Scripture tells us in Psalm 37, verse 5, says, commit your cares to me, and I will act on them. The Christ, our petitions and our prayers before Almighty God.
For the people of the United States, that we may be united in building a society in which everyone feels safe and have the opportunity to live with dignity and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that we may witness to Christ's love by practicing charity and promoting justice and peace throughout the world.
We pray
for all victims of 9/11 violence and terror, for their families, and for the victims of oppression and violence around the world. For the ability to ensure aid and work for healing and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve in elected office, for men and women of our military, that they may live with courage and wisdom, reflecting the church teaching that the moral test of our society is hard and weak. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders around the world, war and violence, and promote peace, cooperation, and development, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us ask our Blessed Mother, the Queen of America, as we sing. Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Gracious God, hear this consent we have brought before. Listen to all the orders we carry in our hearts, and please accept and grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please. Bread in your own, our bodies. failing hearts renew. Our lives belong to you, our Lord and God. Blessed are you, God, for creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made to become our bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, God, for creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and hope of human hands become our spiritual food. Blessed be God forever. We accept that our mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at hand
for the praise and glory of his name. Ever offer as we celebrate this hallowed day in this free on 9th September. On 11th September, as we remember their memories, we will never forget their families who daily bear the pains of loss and grief. Relieve their pain and suffering and give them hope and cheer. On this day of sacred memory, we ask for grace and prayer to live more the nobleness of our nation and to become better servants of yours. Better sons and daughters, better neighbors. Until that great day when we shall all see war no more, we will live in peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and
that we should give you thanks and praise, O God Almighty Father. Through our Lord Jesus Christ. By your leading, our ancestors brought forth on this continent a great nation, born of faith and struggle, of war and peace, freedom, characterized by justice and courage, and committed to striving for promotion of the common good. For though the human race is divided by dissension and discord, yet we know that by testing us, you change our hearts to prepare them for reconciliation. Even more, by your Spirit, you move human hearts. May speak, adversaries may join hands, and people may seek to make. By the working of your power, hatred is overcome. Revenge gives way to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. Therefore, as we give you ceaseless thanks with the choirs of heaven, we cry out to your majesty on earth, as without end we are king. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Out of all holiness. Make holy therefore this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, the Lord Jesus took bread, giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the Lord took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. With the first acclamation, let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess the resurrection until we come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that by taking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, whom we lost on a day like this 19 years ago. Remember all those we've lost thereafter. Grant, dear Lord, that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now rise as one family and pray in the words our Lord gave us. Our Father,
who art
in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, as it is in heaven. Give us this day our as we forgive those who trespass against us, not to temptation, but deliver us from them. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God. Lord Jesus Christ, we said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, let us wave to each other God's peace. Lamb of God,
who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, graciously hear us.
Look up, my sisters and brothers, look up and behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall live. May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Within you, Lord, is the fountain of life, and in your light we see light. And of war, plenty, and of want, of justice and discrimination, of health, and of sickness, phases of life and death. In this memorial, we implore you, help us to show our gratitude by sharing the face of freedom, of tolerance, compassion, sacrifice. In the spirit of those we lost, help us to rise to the challenge of this moment and with a more unified purpose, overcome our battles against oppression, violence, and especially this pandemic. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before the final lesson, let us listen. Prayer to St. Michael Archangel. Prayer to St. Michael Archangel. St. Michael Archangel, defend us in battle.
Yeah.
We are defense against the wickedness and sins of the devil.
May God
make you humble and pray, and to the prince of the heavenly host. By the power of God, cast into hell, Satan and all the evil spirits,
who prowl around
the world,
seeking the ruins of souls. Amen.
So before the final blessing, I'd like to take a moment to express my thanks to all our religious affairs specialists that helped us today. Without notice, they have given an exceptionally dedicated time to our service today, and I'm so grateful for your time. I appreciate it. And thanks to all of you for being here. It's always a beautiful day. Everything that happened today is that you are still in the light. Very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
By your heads and pray for us, please. Most merciful God, watch over us and keep us safe. Provide for us in every good way. And help us by your grace to model our lives according to the pattern of your Christ. For we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Through the prayers of St. Michael Archangel and our blessed mother, may God bless and keep you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dear friends, this Mass is ended. We go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks.
We're going to sing the song, God Bless America.
God bless America, land that I love, stand beside God and guide God from it. Why?